Hi, in this video we'll be looking at a fat burning hormone called glucagon. So I'll be explaining what is glucagon, what is the relationship between insulin and glucagon, and what are the three different ways in which you can trigger glucagon. So let's get started. So glucagon is one of the main fat burning hormones. There are other hormones as well, but glucagon is one of the main fat burning hormones. So if insulin is the main fat storing hormone, glucagon is the opposite. It is the fat burning hormone. So let's understand the relationship between these two hormones first, like how they work together, and then I'll explain you the three different ways in which you can trigger glucagon. Okay, so now what is the role of insulin in your body? The main job of insulin is to regulate the extra blood sugar that is floating in your bloodstream. So whenever your blood sugar rises above normal range, pancreas secretes out insulin in your body and it brings down the sugar level. So its main job is to control high levels of sugar in your body. So what does glucagon does? Glucagon does the opposite. So whenever your sugar levels drops down, or whenever you have not eaten for a longer period of time, same way as pancreas secretes out insulin, pancreas also secretes out glucagon, and it does so for the purpose that your blood sugar does not drop too low. So glucagon also controls your sugar level. So they both work like a seesaw, and they both have an inverse relationship. So whenever your insulin levels are high, your glucagon will be low, and whenever your insulin levels are low, your glucagon will be high. So we want a situation where glucagon will be high, as it helps in more fat burning. Also, whenever glucagon is high, it releases an enzyme called HSL. Now let's look into the three different ways in which you can trigger glucagon. Okay, so now the first thing you can do is to have a low carbohydrate diet, especially cutting down on refined carbohydrates and high glycemic foods. So when I say refined carbohydrates, I mean to say that carbohydrates which have been stripped off from its nutrient and fiber content. So examples would be your sugar, sweets, pizza, pasta, cereals, biscuits, prepackaged foods, sports drinks, fruit juices, white flour, maida. So the list goes on. So these are all the refined carbohydrates in your diet, and they are also high in glycemic index. So whenever you consume these refined carbohydrates, your blood sugar level rises very quickly, and also your insulin levels goes up. So you need to avoid these refined carbohydrates, and overall your carbohydrate consumption should be low. So if your carbs are low, your blood glucose levels will fall and it will trigger glucagon to rise, and it will draw energy, glucose, from the liver glycogen and also from your own body fat. So that's the magic of glucagon. It taps into your own body fat for energy purposes. So that's why the very low carbohydrate diet like the keto diet and also intermittent fasting works, because of this fat burning hormone glucagon. So keto diet is actually a very scientifically researched diet, and it's not at all a fat diet. Okay, so now the second way in which you can trigger glucagon is to include intense resistance strength training workouts and also high intensity interval training. So when I say intense strength resistance training, I mean to say exercises, lifts which involve your entire body. So it would be your intense sets of squats, deadlifts, bench press, overhead press, Olympic lifts like the clean and jerk, snatches. So these are all exercises, lifts which involve your entire body, and it gives you an adrenal rush which triggers glucagon. Also, looking at the endurance side, you can include high intensity interval training. So you can include more of, say, jumping jack, burpees, skipping ropes. So include all these exercises. Also, if you are running on treadmill, so keep changing your intensity. So increase your intensity for 5 minutes, then drop down your intensity, then again increase your intensity. So there are different techniques in which you can include high intensity interval training. Okay, so now the third way in which you can trigger glucagon is to include good high quality protein source foods. So that would be your eggs, paneer, cottage cheese, chicken, fish, meat, protein powders. So these are all high quality first class protein source food. Also, if you are a vegetarian, you need to mostly focus on milk and milk products. So that would be paneer, cheese, curd, protein powders. So you need to consume more of these products. And also, if you are thinking that I'll meet my protein goals through dal, legumes, pulses, beans, chickpeas, then let me tell you, these are all second class protein source foods. When I say second class, it means that one or more essential amino acids are missing in these food. Also, they are a bit high on carbohydrate intake. So if you are planning to include these second class protein source foods in your diet, then be watchful of your overall carbohydrate consumption, as that might increase. So these were the three ways in which you can trigger glucagon. Also, if you would like to consult with me regarding your nutrition, or if you want to consult with me regarding fitness, then you can directly reach out to me on the details that I'll be sharing below this video. Till then, if you have liked this video, please give it a thumbs up, share it with others, and do subscribe to my channel MitFit for more videos on health, fitness, and nutrition. Thank you.